Good evening, crafting friends. I'm Dorene Decibus from It Begins With Ink and Paper, and welcome to Funfold Friday. I hope you've had a great week, and I really hope get a crack at your Christmas shopping this week. I know that I finally did some today, but I've been really remiss at getting it done. I have Christmas presents I still have to make, and I have Christmas cards I have to get out. They're made, but I have to get them addressed and get them out. So I thought I would take a break from Christmas and the holidays tonight for Funfold Friday. We're making an envelope fold, and I'm going to add a little special treat on the inside of the card. But I decided to make something from our online exclusive store and not try to find designer series paper that's still in stock. Most of our Christmas paper has been sold out, and I would prefer to share with you some things that are in stock right now. So that's why we are working with some brighter colors, if you can see below. I am using the stylish shape dies tonight. I'm using the, fourth die. So fourth die from the middle, one, two, third die from the outside. So I'm using that as one of our tools tonight. I'm also using, and this is one of our online exclusives, this is the basic borders die, and it's just awesome. We're doing an envelope fold tonight. I could have used this as my envelope, or this one here, or even this one here, anything that I wanted. I'm using this die tonight, so I'm going to take that die out so I can show you how I'm going to use it. And I'm using the translucent florals cling stamp set. I love the cling stamp sets. They're my favorite. And this one gives you such variation of color as you stamp. I think you're going to love it. So that's just something I want to point out. And let's take a look at the card we're going to make tonight. As I said, it's an envelope fold. And this is the outside of the card. It has a front that is going to look like an envelope. Is this inside? One is this surprise. Let me just make sure everything's working okay. One is this surprise right here on the inside of the card. And then if we open it more, you're going to see at the bottom of the card, we have a gift card holder. So that's the other little surprise. And then to close it, I have this piece here that I cut out with the stylish shapes die, and then my floral image. And I only put dimensionals right at the bottom so that can slip right in underneath and hold the card shut. So let me just put that to the side. I do want to share with you the beautiful designer series paper that we are using. And this is it. It is the Delightful Floral 12x12 Designer Series paper. And the colors that it coordinates with are Berry Burst, Blackberry Bliss, Bubble Bath, Calypso Coral, Fresh Freesia, Lemon Lolly, Parakeet Party, Pool Party, and Pretty Peacock. So this is just gorgeous Designer Series paper. I'm just going to open it part of the way and let you see both sides. So we have these floral images here, and then on the back we have some Berry Burst. You get two sheets of those. Here we have some of the leaves with the Parakeet Party and the Pretty Peacock. And on the back side of these two, we have the Pretty Peacock ink. This piece is just so delicate. It's just gorgeous. I love the flowers on it, and I just love the delicate nature. And on this side, we have the Calypso Coral. Here we have some of the larger images. We could cut these out, add them as embellishments on the card. And when I flip it over, we get some of that bubble bath paper. Here we have more of the leaves. And on the back, we have the pool party. And then this is the design that I'm using tonight with the diagonal images of the florals. And so let me just put this out of the way. Okay. And let's get started for what we need tonight. So, we are going to need, let's start with the fresh Freesia cardstock. This is a piece of 5.5 by 10.5 inches. So I cut a half inch off of the length and then cut it at 5.5. We're going to be scoring that in a minute. I'm going to need a piece of basic white cardstock that's going to go on the inside. And this measures 4 by 5.25. I also have a piece of basic white cardstock that is just a quarter of the size of paper that we're going to be doing some stamping on. It's a little bigger than a quarter size. We're going to need some of the designer series paper. This measures 3 1/4 inch by 5.5 inches. And then we need a smaller piece of the designer series paper to make that gift card holder. I was first thinking this was going to be a birthday card that we could then add a gift card in. But afterwards, I was thinking that I didn't really want to put a greeting on it because it could be lots of things. So I decided to keep it as is. It could be a wedding card. It could be a thank you, lots of different things. And so this piece is optional. You could leave the bottom of the card blank so that you could be writing a message to the recipient. But this measures 2 7/8 inches by 3 1/4 inches. All right, so let's start with doing our stamping. I think that would be the best thing to start with. So I am going to start with the fresh Freesia. And I am going to be stamping 2 of the flowers. So I'm just going to ink up my stamp. And I'm going to stamp one right here. And you can see how the stamp does a nice variegation with the colors of the ink. I love that about this stamp set. Second one. This stamp set is available in the current mini catalog and will be so until the first week in January. So that's something to think about. So I'm going to cover up my fresh Freesia ink. We're going to need it for another part, but I don't want to mistakenly put a stamp in the wrong place. And I am going to stamp a leaf. And what I'm going to do first is I'm going to stamp off of it because I don't want it as dark. I think, let me start that again. Make sure we got ink all over. Stamp off and then stamp on the paper. You can see how dark it is over here. It's a little lighter here, and that's what I want when I cut it. I want to have a little bit of lightness there. So I'm going to set this aside because through the magic of television, I have already die cut those 3 images. And then at the same time, I die cut the circle. So I am going to put this together in a little bit. So we'll move those out of the way and close this ink pad and get to work on our card. So I'm going to take my card, and I'm going to get out my favorite tool. This always opens up on me. It is my scoreboard, and let me just grab my scoring tool. Again, this is 5.5 by 10.5, and I'm going to score at 3 inches and at 7 1/4 inches. There we go. And that is all the scoring we need to do tonight. Easy peasy. Put those 2 things away. Now, I am not even going to cut this yet. So that's my 3-inch side. This is the side I want. I mean, not cut. I'm going to add my piece of designer series paper. And it looks like I might be having some internet issues tonight. I'm sorry about that. I am going to make sure at one end, I'm going to put some extra adhesive because that is going to be, and it's the wrong end, of course, that is because of cutting the flap. I want to make sure that it's on straight. So I'm going to add this to that front flap. And then what I'm going to do is I want to line this up so that I can get the center of this. So I'm going to just bring this up a little higher so you can see. Let's see, I need to have 2 3/4 inches. So there's 2 1 2 3/4. And I have 1 2 3/4. So this black line right here in the center of my cardstock. So I've got it lined up. So I have 2 3/4 on either side. I'm going to take my pencil, which I had a moment ago out here, but it looks like it's gone. So let me grab another pencil. And I am going to put a mark right here. It is going to be cut off, so I don't need to worry about that. And that is where I'm going to know to line up my envelope, my die that I'm going to be using. So I'm going to put that right along the edge, the very point, right along that edge. And then I like to use post-it note tape. It's just like a post-it note. I get it on Amazon, and to hold this in place. All right. So then I'm going to, and through the Magic TV, I have it right here. And what I actually did was, I want to show you this. I cut it a second time. So I wanted this little piece. It made it a little shorter, which helps for my card, but then I'm going to use this piece on the inside. So I'm going to turn my card over, and what I'm going to do is take this piece and attach it right on the top of the card, and it gives it that really pretty look. So let me add some adhesive to this. And it doesn't match it 100%, because it would match it 100% like this if I did it upside down. But I'm going in this direction. So what I'm going to do is I am going to just start it on one side, bring it right up to the tip, and then make sure my other side is right up to the tip as well, and it will line up fine on your card. So we have that really pretty, oops, I got some of the, didn't put that tape on far enough. So let's just get that on both sides. There we go. So now we have that beautiful accent piece right here at the top of the inside of the card. All right. So, as I said, I wasn't going to be putting I'm not going to be putting in a greeting yet. So, on my piece of basic white cardstock, I am going to be putting some adhesive on my floral piece here. Now, I could have just stamped right here on my piece of cardstock, but I like the texture of it by adding that piece. So I'm going to just add some adhesive to this. And this is going to go right in the middle of our card. So I'm just going to lay this out. And before I forget, I am going to use my bone folder, which again, I had out, and I just don't know where my stuff is disappearing tonight. It's somewhere. We won't use a bone folder, but I do like to get these nice creases. I'm going to fold here. And I am ready to go. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do, if you remember on the front of the card, I did some stamping because I didn't like leaving this just plain. I could have embossed it as well, but I just wanted to do some stamping. So I am going to get out this little vine stamp, and I'm going to stamp ink on color and color and stamp with the Fresh Freesia ink. And I'm just going to start on one side, and I am going to be going in different directions. Now, I put a piece of paper inside the card because I didn't want to stamp off. And if I opened it up, then I might stamp off on the back. So I just decided to do it this way. So you just have to turn your stamp around in lots of different directions and just fill in the area. Just a fun way to add some extra elements to your card. And you can hit all your spots. If you see an area that you'd like something, and I want just a little piece right there, I think that looks great now. And let's get this out of the way. So now when I close the card, I've got this beautiful front to it, and having all this, that little stamped area. Gift card yet. So what I'm going to do, this is going to go right here along the side. I cut this so it really fits in nicely on that panel, and I tested it. It does fit a gift card this size, but you would not want to go smaller. So here I have my 1.5-inch punch. Just going to punch a piece out, and that way we have a little opening. Now, I don't have any gift cards to show you. This goes in really nicely. I used my credit card, and I don't really want to show my credit card on live Facebook. So you're just, for tonight, going to have to take my word for it. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use tear and tape to put on the back of this. I'm going to put it right up to the edge, so it gives me all the space I need. And I want you to notice I didn't go all the way up here, and I'm going to do the same over here. I like to be able to lift the whole edge when I'm putting my gift card in, and doing it that way just helps out nicely. So again, I'm going to put this down, go as close to the edge as I can, leaving that little space there. And then I'm just going to put a piece along the bottom to hold so the gift card doesn't slide out. Okay, I'm just gonna press those down. And then I am going to take my my pick your toolkit and open, take off that, those adhesive backings. And now I can put this right on the inside of my card. And I'm just going to go right even with where the white cardstock is. Make sure it's straight. And doesn't that just look pretty on the inside? We have up here the top of the card, and then as we go down, we have another piece of that beautiful designer series paper. So now it's time to get the front all set. So what I'm going to start with, just on the back side, and I'm going to add my leaf. Oh, I hope I'm not losing my internet tonight. And I apologize if I am. I know I'm still taping, but those of you watching live may see a little break in the video, and I apologize for that. Or I might have just paused it myself. See if that does anything. I'm going to take the backings off of my dimensionals. And this is going to go right on the front of the label. And then for the label itself, I am going to be putting my three dimensionals down towards the bottom. So I'm going to put them right at the bottom, make it in a little bit of a U shape, pull these off. And then while the card is closed, I'm going to be putting that right on the front. And there we have our closed card. And all we need to do is open it, is to open that side, and this is what we get. Well, that, and then it's easy to put back in, just slide it in like that. Well, that's it for Funfold Friday. So a little bit of a change from our Christmassy and holiday cards. I hope you join me Sunday night for some more fun with the Trucking Along stamp set in Simply Stamping Sunday. And I hope you join me next Friday night for another edition of Funfold Friday. Be looking for a pop-up video this weekend. I am going to be sharing my load that I've got from the new mini coming up in January. Thank you, Barbara. I'm so glad you and Janice are joining me tonight. That's it for me tonight. I will see you all tomorrow night. Sunday night for Simply Stamping Sunday. Next Friday for Funfold Friday. And sometime tomorrow for you to see my unboxing video. Good night, everybody. Have a great weekend.